All right, something.
Hi, folks, it's good to be with you today. God bless you. Love to everybody out there. Father, we thank you for this day. We give you the praise and the glory. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, these three are one. We ask in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, Father, in his name, that you might anoint the ministry of your word, that you might fill this place with the power of your Holy Spirit, that every demonic force will be bound today. No weapon formed against thee shall prosper. And we pray today, ripples of power, ripples of grace would flow in this place and in this area for your glory, Lord Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God that was slain for us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
It says in the Word of God, John chapter 4, verse 29, verse 10, Jesus answered and said unto her, if thou knewest the gift of God, and who it is that says to thee, give me to drink, thou would have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water. Living water.
Hallelujah.
Living water. God wants to give you living water today. Life that is abundant, life that is joyful, life that is filling, life that is satisfying, living water. Have you got living water in your life today, or are you drinking poison water? The poison water of drugs, the poison water of fame, the poison water of sexual immorality. These are poison waters that will drag you down, and they will poison your mind, and they will poison your heart. But God will give you living water, living water, living hope, living joy, living peace by the power of the Holy Ghost. Do you have living water today? Do you have living joy, living power, living hope? Are you living in the power of the Holy Spirit today? Have you come to Christ, know Christ, love Christ? Is Christ your all today? I have come to give you living water, he said. Living water, but are you living on fame and power and sex and drugs? Are you living on mammon, thinking that money is all the answer? They are not the answer, my friend. Money is not the answer. Sex is not the answer. Drugs is not the answer. Getting blooded on a Saturday night is not the answer. Wacky-backy ain't the answer.
Hallelujah.
Spice ain't the answer.
Hallelujah.
Drugs ain't the answer.
Hallelujah.
He said, I've come to give you living water. She met Jesus at the well. Now Jesus went to her. She was a woman in her culture despised. They despised her. She was a woman that had had five men, and the other man that she had was not even her husband. She was a woman. Are you probably okay? Are you alright? Are you Christian? Yeah, God bless you. Preach the word, yeah? Living water. Living water. He came to her. And she was a woman despised in her community. Despised. Because she'd had five men. And now she got another guy who wasn't even her husband. And she had shame in her life. And nobody wanted to talk to her. Nobody wanted to be with her. But it says, and Jesus must go. He had to go and meet her. He had to go to the brokenhearted. He had to go to the despised. And he had to go to the Samaritan woman who was despised and rejected of men. And Christ came to those. Christ has come to the despised. He's come to the brokenhearted. He comes to you in your brokenness. You might try to hide your brokenness. You might try to hide your drug addiction. You might try to hide your porn addiction. You might try to hide your addictions today, your brokenness today, your sin today, and you want to hide it. But Jesus knows your brokenness. He knows your addiction. He knows that it's there. And now Jesus comes to her, and he wants to fix her. He wants to give her living water. And God wants to fix your brokenness today. He wants to give you living water, hope that will set you free. So he came to her and he said something to her. What did he say? He said, you have had five husbands And the one you have now is not your husband. Now you and I would have said, hey, I don't like that. I don't like it, Jesus, that you're pointing out my sin. I don't like it, Jesus, that you're pointing out that my failure, my mistakes. But in order to get the healing of God, in order to get the forgiveness of God, in order to get the goodness of God, God has to put his finger on the things that are wrong in our life.
Amen.
He has to put the finger on the things that are wrong in our life. He has to do it. Real love is tough love. Real love is tough love. If you've got a little kid who's 5 years of age and won't clean its bedroom, you're not going to let the kid off. You're going to say, clean your bedroom, to teach it discipline. Tough love. Tough love. And Jesus is showing tough love. He's saying, look, I want to give you living water. But before you get that living water, you have had 5 husbands, and the guy that you have now is not your husband. He was pointing to a sin in her life. And sometimes you have to deal with the pain that's there, the things that you've done wrong. You have to face up to it that you have done something that you know you should not have done. What do you need to face up to right now? There is something that you have done and you keep doing that you will hide from us, but you need to face up to that, because if you don't face up to it, you will never be set free. You will never be set free until you face up to the thing that you will not face up to. The thing that you keep hiding, that sin, that thing that you keep doing, and you keep doing it and doing it until you face up to it, there will never be deliverance. There'll be never cleansing, never love, never joy, never power. You have to face up to your sin.
Hallelujah!
You have to be honest with yourself and honest with God. And Jesus said, you have had 5 husbands, and the one that you have is not your husband. He put the finger on the pulse and said, you need to deal with it, and to deal with it now. Now, do you know what she did? She said, I hear that you worship on a different mountain. She now wanted to dodge the challenge of Jesus with a theological question. And it's what you do with the preacher when the preacher preaches sin. What do you do? Are you, brother? God bless you. How you doing? This is my brother from another mother. God bless you, brother. How you doing? My brother from another mother.
Amen.
She,
in the name of Jesus.
She tried to get out of the finger being pointed to a sin with theological arguments. You worship on a different mountain. When the street preacher preaches sin, you say, you believe in 6-day creation. And you try to hide from your sin by causing arguments about creation or evolution. You try to dodge the question.